is
not that.
Contemporary is more like
it's like a stylish thing.
Yeah, it's because it depends on the teacher. Mm-hmm. That's why it's like we can't really give an answer for what contemporary is, it's really different.
No, I would like looked up contemporary just to make sure I like understood, and it was just like dancing with emotions and showing.
Yeah, totally. It can be that. But that's a common Oh, you're in financial school. So are your parents doing PTS?
Yes.
Crossroads.
Hi.
I'm Rebecca. What's your name?
Risa.
Risa, nice to meet you. Are you also with them?
No.
You're in PTS?
I'm part of Virgo Heart.
Oh, cool. Yes. Oh, awesome. That's great. Who's the school leader of that this quarter?
There are two school leaders. So there's Paul, not Paul Childers, but there's a guy. I don't know his last name. And then there's Samantha Meyer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Cool. That's awesome. Yeah, where did you get your DTS?
I did it in Australia.
Nice.
So I just came back this December and then started working on it.
That's great.
Yeah.
Sorry, your name one more time?
Risa.
Risa.
Sorry,
I can get these blanks.
No, it's okay.
Risa, Alina,
yeah.
Bethany, and Rebecca. You clean our studio.
Yeah.
I'm like, I recognize that face.
Are you thinking more cleaning?
What?
Is there anything you see that I should be doing more?
No. It looks great.
Okay.
What was your name again?
Emily.
Nice to meet you.
And wait, what's your name?
Rebecca.
Okay, Rebecca. Yeah.
A little bit, but
yes,
there we go.
Yeah. Switch places, yeah, so that you're in the front. Does that make sense? Yeah, okay, cool. Okay, so a little introduction before we start. My name is Rebecca, and I'm with the Hartridge Performing Arts Ministry here. Right now, we're just a DTS. Actually, no, that's not true. We are, right now, we're running a Hartridge Junior Camp. It's our second year doing that. And basically what that is we have high school students, international high school students come to this campus and get like a mini DTS in 1 month. Yeah, so we pretty much run our DTS in 1 month for them. So they have lectures, and then in the afternoon they have skill training, and then they put on their own production. They have a project by the end that they're gonna present to us and whoever else wants to come. And then in April we run our DTS, which is performing arts, and we train dance, music, acting, and we have a 1 hour and 30 minute show that we teach, and then that's what we take on outreach. So that's a little bit about our ministry. I co-lead that, and yes, I also teach open classes here. I teach ballet and contemporary, so you'll see me on Wednesday. And let's see, I think that's enough introduction. I was praying about this class for this quarter, and the word that I received was freedom. And one thing I felt, and I've used this so many times, but I just love it, is that when we receive boundaries, we actually have more freedom. Some people think that, oh no, no boundaries is freedom, but actually the Lord gives us boundaries, and within those boundaries there is freedom. And that reminds me a lot of ballet, because ballet is so black and white, whereas other dance is a little bit more free, but it's in that black and white that we are actually able to be more free, because ballet is the foundation. Yeah, it teaches us balance, it teaches us flexibility, it teaches us strength, and so I really love that through ballet we can actually get more freedom in our dancing rather than less. So that's just the word that I have for you. I hope that you enjoy that black and whiteness of this class. And I've come to have a real love for ballet, and like it when I first started dancing, but praise the Lord that He changed that in my heart. Yeah. So I'm just going to go ahead and pray for us, and then we'll start. God, I thank you so much for dance. And I thank you, Lord, for ballet. I thank you for the freedom that it brings us. And God, I pray over every single person that's here today. God, I pray that they would know that they didn't just come to a ballet class, but they came to an hour with an opportunity to encounter you through this gift, Lord. And I just pray, God, that you would completely take over this class, that you would speak to everybody individually while they are dancing. You give us revelations of who you are, Father. And would you give me revelations of who you are that I can share with every single one of them? And Lord, I just bless these women. I pray absolutely no fear in this place in Jesus' name, and that you would cast all fear out, God, and we would know that this is a judgment-free zone, that we are dancing in the presence of the Lord, and there is absolutely no fear in that place, God. So we just give this class to you, and we love you in Jesus' name. Amen. So first, you guys can all actually spread out all over. I always start my class with a little bit of a warm-up before we hit the bar. So and you're going to want to be a little bit away from the bar, because it's going to travel that way. You'll see in a second. So I'll do this with you today, but later and throughout the quarter, I'll probably just walk around and give directions. So it starts with our head dropping forward. Actually, no, that's not true. It starts with us standing in parallel, and there's a whole minute of the song where you get to just stand here, and you can close your eyes, you can breathe, and it's just your time to set your intentions for the class. You can pray, you can find your balance, whatever you're feeling in that moment. And then when I count us in, our head is going to drop forward, and then it's going to go back. We're going to go forward, and we're going to take our ribs with us. Yeah, we're going to go a little further, and then we're going to go back. We're going to go forward again, and this time we take our knees with us, and then we go one more time back. And then we're going to roll all the way down, and we're going to hold here with straight legs. Then we're gonna hold for 1 8 count. Then we will bend our knees and stretch 4 times. Again, bend and stretch, bend and stretch, bend and stretch. And then on that last one, you're gonna pivot over to your left leg in front. Yeah, both of my legs are straight. From here, I'm gonna bend the back leg. and I'm going to do something you've probably never done before. I'm going to take that back, this front leg, and I'm going to actually slide it through. Yeah, I'm getting a little deeper stretch in my hamstring when I do this. Then I bend the leg again, and then I'm going to slide it through. This is why you want to be away from the bar so you don't run into it. We do it again, bend, and slide, and last time, bend, and slide to a little bit of a wider second. You're going to turn out, or turn in, and then you're going to roll. Yeah, you see now how you want to be far away from the wall? So we just do a roll. From here, we're going to go to the side. So we go head right, and a little further with our ribs, and a little further with our knees, and then we're going to go head all the way over, and we stretch. One thing here is you don't want to sit into one of your hips, yeah? You should have a flat line. When you look up in the mirror, your hips should be in a flat line. We're going to hold here for an eight count, then we're going to bend the left leg, bend, and stretch, bend, and stretch, bend, and stretch, bend, and you're going to turn again to four. Yeah, right leg is in front now, we bend, and we hold. Again, we bend, and we pull through. Last, this time we only do it three times, bend, and pull through to a small fourth so that we can turn back to the back, and we plie, and we roll. Then we do everything to the other side, yeah? So we'll go ahead, we hold, then we're gonna turn, and our right leg's gonna be in front, and we'll go that way, yeah? One little thing is when you're sliding through, you almost want to imagine that this foot has a gum on it and you're trying to scrape the gum off. So it should actually hear like the sliding on the floor. Yeah, sometimes there will be like some squeakiness. Yeah? Any questions? Okay, let's go. Standing in a parallel position, facing the mirror, making sure you're far away, enough away from the bar. Yes. And just holding here. You can close your eyes. You're here for a minute. Thank you. So when you turn around, you can go in front of them. Okay, so let's start, yeah? Shall we? So we're gonna start simple with pliés. And I was sharing in the beginning of class that the word I received for ballet is freedom. And the plié song that we're using today is to no longer slaves. So wonderful, our chains will be broken in Jesus' name. So we're gonna start in first position. And nice and simple, we're going to use no arm. It's just going to be held in a low fifth position. And we're going to go bend and stretch, bend and stretch. Then we're going to do a, that's called a demi-plié. Plié means to bend. Demi means half. Then we're going to do what's called a grand plié, which is full bend. So we're going to go through demi. We're going to go all the way down without collapsing. Yeah, we're trying to still stay lifted. Then we put our heels back down. We go through our demi. And then we rise up again. Same thing, but now we're going to use our arms. So we're going to breathe, and we're going to lift. It's going to come through first. We open through second. Then we go all the way down and back through demi. Open, tendu, same thing in second position. Arms going to come right back down. So we go demi-plié and stretch, demi-plié and stretch. Grand plié. This time the heels do not come off the floor, yeah? This is the only position where our heels don't come off the floor in grand plié. We go back through demi and lift. Then we're going to use our arms. Breathe and stretch through first and open. Grand plié. Arms go the exact same pathway. Now, since there's a tiny little coda, we're going to do something different here. We're going to go plié. We're going to rise up. Warm up our feet a little bit. Plié. Rise up. Plié. Tendu, close, fourth. Same thing. Demi and stretch. Demi and stretch. Grand plié. Knees are moving away from each other. Down and lift. Demi, stretch. Demi, stretch. Grand plié. And tendu, close, fifth. Now, in fifth position, we want our toes and our heels to be together. Yeah? But because I am no longer training, I do it in a third position. So if you feel more comfortable doing a third, then please, which is just right in between, yeah? It doesn't hit all the way your toes. I use a third so I can work my turnout. Please do that if you would like. If not, you want to challenge yourself, go all the way to fifth, feel free. But don't let me confuse you. So, then we go demi and stretch, grand plié. Arm is just being held right here, it's still nice and strong. Demi and stretch, demi. Stretch, grand, six, and seven, and eight. Same thing we did in second. Plié, lift, plie, lift, plie, tendu, closing first. Then keeping our arm in second, we're gonna go plie, four starch, rise up, and down. Two slow, plie, four starch, rise up, then four fast. Plie, two, three, four, plie, two, three, four, plie, two, three, four. Then we're gonna reverse it. Up, and down, and down, da 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 da. Then four fast. Then at the very end, we're gonna plie, we're gonna bring our arms all the way to high fifth. We're gonna try to bring our arm off the bar, and we're gonna balance here. Okay, and then we always finish at the bar. It's like the period at the end of a sentence. We wanna complete what we just did. Yeah, or else it's just like, bleh. Yeah? Okay, questions on that? It's a lot for those of you who probably never taken. But let's just go ahead and try it, okay? So you're gonna start with your right hand on the bar, yeah? So those of you on this side will start, is this my right hand?
Yeah.
No, we'll start with our left hand on the bar. I'm so sorry. So yes, left hand starts on the bar. Yes, there you go, awesome. Okay, for those of you who have taken ballet, there's no prep, it just starts right away, plie, okay? Ready? So first position, and I'm gonna start. Plie. Nice and slow so we can detail I want to point out is the difference between a demi and a grand. So when we do our demi plies, they're always heels will be on the floor. Yeah? So when I go demi plie, I should never see that. Yeah, that works in actually a different muscle than what we're trying to accomplish. Yeah? So we're holding here and stretch, heels down and stretch. Then I go heels down, heels lift, heels back down and stretch. And that is in every single position except which one? Anybody remember? Yeah, Lisa got it in second. So what happens in second? Or what doesn't happen in second?
When we go for grand plie, instead of looking at our ankles, I mean, heels, just go all the way.
They stay on the floor. Very good. Good. Everyone have it? Okay, other side. We're getting a nice workout in our calves with all the girl days. Ready? And stretch. And down. And stretch. Grandpa. Down. And drop. And down. And lift. Now with the arm, our breeze up. And down. It comes to first. Turn in, yeah? So you're gonna move from your hip socket. So I'm not just moving my toe, right? I'm taking my entire leg and I'm turning it in, I'm turning it back out, and I close. Then I go tendu, I flex the foot, I point again, and I close. Next one is I tendu, I lift it off the floor, I put it back down, and I close. Then I'm gonna do two just slow tendus. Tendu and close, tendu and close. Now I'm gonna do it to the side with timing. 6, 7, and I go point, in, out, and close, point, flex, point, and close, point, lift off, and close, out, and in, out to the back, and tendu, in, out, close, tendu, flex, point, close, tendu, lift, tendu, close, out, and in, out, last time to the side, in, out, close, tendu, flex, point, close, stretch, lift off, point, and stretch, and close. This is a little different. Stretch, I'm gonna plie in fifth, yeah? It should be in front, 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 front. That working leg should go in front so that I can soutenu. I unwind myself, turn away, plie, stretch, and I'm gonna do everything to the other side. Yeah, so last time we stopped, yeah, and we like turned around. This time we're gonna just do it right away. Okay, so the combination, tendu, in, out, close, tendu, flex, point, close, tendu, lift. I'm sorry, but you're not doing it from fifth. Don't let that confuse you. So after, let me just walk to the center. So after I close in front, I soutenu around, plie. I'm gonna do my first tendu, in, out, and then I'm gonna close that first. Yeah, because I still want us to work from first. I don't want us to work from fifth yet. So we're gonna go close back to first, okay? So don't let that position confuse you. Then we do everything again, last time, plie, soutenu. This time we're gonna balance in what's called a coupe. So you're gonna lift your foot off. You can just hold this position. You can also lower your leg, or sorry, your heel if this position is new to you, and you can try and balance here. If you feel up for it, you can balance here and hold as long as you want. Then we're gonna fifth, soutenu again, to lift off the front leg, hold, and then we close, and then soutenu to finish. Okay, I'll call hold that out. All right, let's try it. First position, arm preparation, 5, 6, 7, 8. Arm is just holding in second, okay? So we're gonna have our left hand on the bar. Yeah, so Risa, you wanna, yeah, switch a room? Thank you guys. You're awesome.
Switch over when we
sit down
and go over it.
Oh, yeah, just, I'll go back there. So let's start there. All right, ready? From first. Two stop, come on. Out, turn around. Yep. Into the bar. Lift up the front leg. Good. Hold it there. Try to find your balance wherever you need it to be. And closing in fifth. And soutenu around. And plie finish. Good, you guys. Okay, let's move on. So, this one's a little easier. This one, we're going to actually face the bar, okay? So you don't have to worry about all this hard stuff. Yeah, you can just have your arms on the bar. So, we're going to be in our first position again, and we're going to do what's called a dégagé, which means to disengage. So, the difference between a tendu and a dégagé is the tendu disengages from the floor, so it lifts off, and then it closes. Yeah? So, we're going to do eight with the right leg. It's going to look like this. And in. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And we're going to switch over to the other leg. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Then we're going to need it. Then we're going to do four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, two, one. Two, one, two, then one. One and a one and a one and a one. Okay? So we're transferring our weight. Yeah? The goal is that our upper body doesn't move. Okay? So what we don't want is for us to be like this. Like a teeter-totter. Yeah? We're trying to keep our legs underneath us, which is a challenge, and we're trying to stay as small as possible with our upper body. It's gonna move slightly, but not like crazy with our leg. Yeah? So, hello. So we're gonna hold nice and tight on the bar. We're gonna do it twice through. If that is already a challenge for you, keep your arms on the bar. Yeah? If not, second time around, arms are gonna come to high fifth. You're gonna try with no arms. Okay? But if you're already like, ah, the legs, keep the arms there. Yeah? Okay. Ready?
Out, in, out, in, out.
in, out, in. I would go double front, double side, double back, double side. Yeah. If you're like, what the heck is a frappe? Just stick with the regular ones. Then we're going to do all that again. So just slow and in, slow and in, slow and in, slow and in, out and 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 out. After the last one, we're going to bring our leg back to that coupe position that we learned earlier. And you can either do this on flat or you can rise up. Now what's going to happen, I'm going to turn to the side so everyone can see, is I'm going to go to the back, to the front, to the back, to the front. This is called petite battement, which means little feet, yeah? Actually, no, little feet, little beat. And what I don't want to happen is I don't want my leg moving all over the place, yeah? It's actually, the movement is all happening from my knee and down, so it goes there, yeah? See how this leg is not moving? Yeah? And I'm just going back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. But if you need to, you can go slow, okay? So we're going to do that for 8 counts. Then we're going to hold to the front, and we're going to come to a passe balance. Yeah, so we're going to hold and try to balance here. And then we'll just close spin, and we'll do it all together. So. Okay? All right. So, oh, man, the time just goes by too fast. This will be the last thing we do on the bar. So we all want to start in fifth position with the left hand on the bar, and we're going to press 7.
And all we talked about was what kind of tutus we wanted.
I wasn't even 7.
I remember I had to pop on these dots and I went on the wrong one and I started crying.
She popped on the wrong dot.
I was like three.
And the teacher was like, oh, sweetie,
she
started
crying. Oh, no!
I thought she was being mean when she told me to go on that one.
Yeah.
Thank you.
going to do a little bit more moving. Yeah, now that we've kind of found our balance in the center. So this one's gonna start from fifth, and we're gonna also incorporate a few direction changes in this, so don't get confused. So we're going, coming from fifth, we're gonna prep, seven, eight. We go tendu, close and back. We pick up the other leg, tendu, close and back. We're gonna go dégagé, which is off the floor, close and back, dégagé off the floor, close and back. Now we're gonna do something we haven't done yet, which is a battement, just means feet, large feet, yeah? So we're gonna lift up, down, and up, and down. Then we're gonna do another thing we haven't done yet, is rondejon, which means circle of the leg. So we're gonna point in front, it's gonna circle all the way around, it's gonna come through again, then we're gonna go point, and then we're actually gonna rondejon, and then we're gonna close it back to face to the other side. Okay, so that leg, the circle takes us around, we just kind of pivot on our foot. Yeah, and then we're gonna go forward. So this is where it gets a little confusing. So right hip picks up again, and close. Pick it up, we're coming from the back, we go dégagé, close, dégagé, close, you go battement, close, battement, close, you go tendu, rondejon, tendu, rondejon, face back. Yes, now we're gonna switch and we're gonna pick up the left foot. So, my left leg's in back, sorry. My left leg's in back, I'm gonna go tendu, close, front, tendu, close, front, dégagé, dégagé, battement, battement, and tendu, rondejon, tendu, face the other side, close, front. Now my left leg is gonna pick up again, but I'm gonna go backwards. Tendu, close, dégagé, close, dégagé, close, battement, and rondejon, carry myself front. And that's where we end. Yeah, we should end with our right leg in front. Are there any questions on that line? That's a little tricky. I'm gonna do it with you. Okay, let's start a little more forward because we're gonna move that way. All right. And fifth. Eventually, after you master that, you turn that into a pirouette, sorry. which looks like this. You just go up, up, and up. You see all the positions? Yeah. So if you're feeling upward, you can do that today. Okay? So we'll start from the side, whichever one you would like to do, the PK step or the PK turn.
Thank you.
are by suggested donation. So, and we just suggest between $5 to $15. So we have a little jar back there. If you feel like dropping a few dollars in there, please feel free. We have all of the funds go towards this dance studio, and then a small portion of it goes towards all the teachers that teach the class. So that's all. Thank you guys. Tomorrow's hip hop and Wednesday is contemporary at the same time. So hope to see you there.
Thanks so much.
Yeah, you're welcome. Corey, let's take a picture.